You might have seen these pictures elsewhere. Wow, they're so detailed and beautiful, right? These are images taken by the Hubble Space Telescope, one of the greatest scientific instruments humans ever made so far, launched in 1990 by NASA. It had recently completed its 30 years of operation, which is a long time. But we want to see more. We want to search for the first galaxies ever formed after the Big Bang by going back in time. We want to know how stars and planetary systems are formed. And most importantly, we want to investigate the potential for life in those systems. Life on another planet will be a huge thing for us. We will be alone in the universe no more. This is where the James Webb Space Telescope comes in. This telescope will answer some of the burning questions we now have today. First started in 1996, and after $10 billion in budgetary costs and numerous delays, we might finally get to see Webb being launched this December, 20 years after its development began. Named after James E. Webb, NASA's administrator that led the Apollo program that landed the first humans on the moon, this telescope will complement and extend the discoveries of the Hubble Space Telescope, which is indeed a beast of a technological marvel we humans have ever created. About 2.7 times larger or 6 times larger in area than Hubble, but with half the mass of Hubble. Webb has more light-gathering power that will enable us to look to longer wavelengths to go beyond what Hubble has already done. The 18 hexagonal mirrors will have a collecting area over 6 times as large as the Hubble. Distant objects which are moving away from us are more redshifted, meaning light that is emitted as ultraviolet or visible light is shifted more and more to redder wavelengths, into the near and mid-infrared part of the light spectrum for very high redshifts. Webb has a much larger primary mirror that can collect more light and has infrared instruments with much more sensitivity than Hubble. This is the costliest mirror we have here on this planet. A $10 billion mirror. It will orbit much farther away from Earth in a colder orbiting temperature compared to Hubble, giving it more stable pointing and higher observing efficiency than with the Earth orbiting Hubble. Webb will be launched in a European Ariane 5 rocket later in December this year from French Guiana in South America. The launch vehicle is part of the European contribution to the Webb mission. This ensures European scientists a fraction of observing time on Webb, roughly 15%. Webb will be in its orbit after about a month of travel, some 1.5 million kilometers away from Earth. This is to avoid swamping the very faint astronomical signals with radiation from the telescope. The cold and stable temperature environment of the orbit will allow Webb to make the very sensitive infrared observations needed. 6 months after launch, Webb will begin its science mission and start to conduct routine science operations. Webb will communicate with Earth using a high-frequency radio transmitter. The telescope will have a mission lifetime of not less than 5.5 years. It will carry fuel for a 10-year lifetime. Hubble is just 600 kilometers away from us, whereas Webb will orbit at approximately 1.5 million kilometers away. And at this distance, it makes post-launch repair or upgrade of the JWST hardware virtually impossible with the spaceships available during the telescope design and fabrication stage. Webb is primarily designed to observe galaxy, star, and planet formation in the universe. To see the very first stars and galaxies form in the early universe, we have to look deep into space, way back in time. The universe is expanding, and therefore, the farther we look, the faster objects are moving away from us, redshifting the light. To study the earliest star formation in the universe, we have to observe infrared light and use a telescope and instruments optimized for this light, since infrareds are less obscured by dust particles. Webb will also detect visible light, too. It will see things 100 times fainter than Hubble can observe. This is about redshift 15 and 30. At these redshifts, the universe is approximately 2% of its current age, which is like 100 to 250 million years after the Big Bang. The Webb will also be able to detect the presence of planetary systems around nearby stars from their infrared light, heat. It will be able to directly see the reflected light of large planets, the size of Jupiter, orbiting around nearby stars. Webb can even see starlight that passes through the planet's atmosphere, measure its constituent gases, and determine whether the planet has liquid water on its surface. It can also observe our solar system. Webb cannot directly see dark matter, the unseen matter that makes up a large fraction of the mass of galaxies and clusters of galaxies, but it can measure its effects. Webb includes four scientific instruments, a camera that will detect the light from the earliest stars and galaxies in the process of formation, the population of stars in nearby galaxies, as well as young stars in the Milky Way and Kuiper Belt objects. The second is a spectrograph that can disperse light from an object into a spectrum. Analyzing the spectrum of an object can tell us about its physical properties, including temperature, mass, and chemical composition. The third instrument has both a spectrograph and a camera. It will provide wide-field, broadband imaging that will continue the breathtaking astrophotography that has made Hubble so universally admired. The Fine Guidance Sensor, FGS, allows Webb to point precisely so that it can obtain high-quality images. It will help in first light detection, exoplanet detection and characterization, and exoplanet transit spectroscopy. NASA is the lead of the project, with significant contributions from the European Space Agency, ESA, and the Canadian Space Agency, CSA. Many nations all over the world contribute to this gigantic project. We are living in an age where humans can launch a highly sophisticated telescope like Webb. This isn't some mediocre achievement. This is a huge one. This is the journey of our species. From the times of ancient Greek to Galileo's papal controversies, we are living in an age where we can observe back in time,